So this is the brand new 911 GT2 RS, which is absolutely phenomenal. So the first thing you'll see, you'll get the carbon front hood, and I also think you'll get like the air vents in the hood. And then when you come around to the side of the car, you also get these really nice carbon vents on the top of the front wheels, which is, I think, inspired maybe from the GT3 RS. You get the wing mirrors in carbon and also this little side panel in carbon right here. And then you'll also get the really big air vents on the side in carbon as well. And then you'll also get the rear wing in carbon. The engine bay is also in carbon as well. So why don't we jump into the car, because I think it'll be a lot quieter in there. So you pull the amazing door handles and then you're in the beautiful GT2 RS. So what not many people know about the GT2 RS is that it doesn't have any door handles. So you just pull this bad boy here and then the door is open and you're ready to get out. So in this car you have to get the PDK gearbox, which is, I think, for me, no problem, because the shifts in the PDK gearbox are absolutely rapid. So here you have the classic Porsche controls like in every other 911. So here you have the all-important exhaust button, so of course you gotta put that on when you start the car up. Here you have the PDK sport button, so that'll basically give you some faster shifts and some more drama into the car as well. So here you have your suspension mode, that'll basically get the car a bit stiffened up. It's really cool, especially when you are on the track. So then you have ESC off and ESC plus traction control off. These two buttons are, I think, for the experienced drivers. Then you have your hazards, your button to lock the car up, a little GT2 RS logo, which is really nice. I think it's like in every Porsche you get like Cayenne or 911. It's always cool that Porsche look up to the small details. You just have, like in every other new 911, the standard interface from Porsche, all these buttons to control this screen right here, and also a really, really nice sport chrono package that's fitted in this car. What also was really remarkable to me is that although you have the sport chrono package, there is no button such like sport or sport plus, and there's also not a switch at the steering wheel to switch between the different driving modes. But I think you don't need it in this car because it's already set up to be a hardcore Porsche. So here you have your fuel consumption, how much fuel you got left, and then here the temperature of the engine, which is really important, I think, because you shouldn't rev a cold engine. I just love, although this is also available in the new GT3, but I just love that the steering wheel is all black. It gives it like a really cool stealth mode, especially because this car is all black, and then with the carbon it's like a really gangster spec, I think. And it also gives a really premium feel in this car with this thing in the center of the steering wheel. It's basically to know that you are going straight instead of your steering wheel being turned to the left or the right. I think this is just like a nice touch, and not many people use this to know that their steering wheel is in the straight position. So here you have the all important cup holders from Porsche, which is really nice, I think. Although this car is like the hardcore fastest 911 they ever built, it even has like cup holders in it, so that's really practical, I think. And then you have the nice door handles, which are already touched up on, and your window controls. Here you can control both windows and your wing mirrors, and also configure it in which position you want them to be. A nice GT2 RS logo embroidered in the headrests, and then back here, it's kind of a GT3 and GT3 RS thing to like embroidered the model of the car in the place where normally the back seats are, but I think it's really cool. They also did it with the GT2RS. So this specific car also has the Porsche logo embroidered in the center console, which is really, really cool. I think it's like kind of a must, I think. This car also has the red contrast stitching around the old steering wheel, which is it's like nice to look at it, but it's like kind of annoying when you have the steering wheel in your hand. But I don't think that's kind of a big problem to deal with in a GT2 RS. So here you normally need to stick the key in to start the car up, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to let someone else do that, that is responsible for this car. And by the way, I think it'll sound absolutely brutal. I think here you have your, yes, here you have your cigarette lighter and like a little storage to put some coins or whatever. And I think we've basically got everything of this car, apart from how fast the car is going and what the 0 to 60 times are. I'll come back to you with that in a minute. And oh, by the way, what's really cool about this car is that it's equipped with the Bose system. And that combined with the all-important comfort seats, I think this could be a nice, not like daily driver, but when you do long trips in this car, I think it could be quite enjoyable. I think what not many people know is that this glass is Gorilla Glass. So it's kind of the same glass that you have on your iPhone and stuff. And this saves in total 113 kilograms. So that's actually quite a bit. And also on the rear window, basically all the windows in this car are made from Gorilla Glass. So that's really cool. Again, a very, very smart move from Porsche. Well, this is when you know your car is really, really new, when the plastic is still around the throttle and brake pedals. Here you have the GT2RS logo that lights up with a nice carbon insert, and then over here you have the seat controls, which is quite cool because with the bucket seats you can't do all of this. These are, I think, 18 ways from Porsche, so that's really cool to have that in your hardcore track focused GT2 RS. So if we close this back up and let's now touch upon the quite more technical things of the new GT2 RS. So the car does 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds and it has its maximum torque at 2,500 RPM, which is 750 Nm. And actually that at 2,500 RPM is mind-blowingly fast, like it's unbelievable. And this car will have 700 horsepower at 7,000 RPM. By the way, when you get to those RPMs, literally the car will fly away or something, I don't know. Its top speed is 340 kilometers an hour, which is, I think, enough for this car. I don't think it needs to be any more. And when you're going 340 kilometers an hour on the Autobahn, for example, I think you'll be quite scared. So let's not try that, I think. Its base price is 291,000 euros. And oh, by the way, if you see a GT2 RS in real life, you'll also notice that it has this like a real nice RS logo on the rear window. So like in the GT3 RS, you get the model name in stickers instead of real plaques. So like in the previous GT2s, you get the two really big exhaust pipes on each side of the car. And also, this is the first time that Porsche introduced a GT2 RS to the 911 Gamma and not a just GT2. And the reason why the RS is added, because obviously it's the fastest 911 ever made, and also it lapped the Nürburgring faster than the 918. So why not add a little RS logo, they thought. Look close enough, you can see that here are the flaps that open and close. I think you'll actually see this really good on the footage I took when the car started up and revved. So I'll cue that later on, but take a close look at that because it's actually really cool. So of course, as I already touched upon, with the YSEC package, you get the quite impressive carbon rear spoiler, and then this engine cover also in carbon. And what's also really cool is that you can see the two turbos in the GT2RS. Well, you don't get that with the GT3 because it doesn't have any turbos. Is that a advantage over a naturally aspirated? I don't know, but all in all, it looks really, really cool. And also a nice touch with this car is that it has guards red seatbelts. By the way, I just want to say congratulations to the owner because this is an immaculate spec, if I do say so myself. So, just some small things for the people who want to. Here is the button to open your hood, and here is the button to open your engine bay. So, also here you have your light controls, which Porsche nails every time. And as I already said, here you have the slot to put your key in. And yeah, basically that's it. So I'm going to wrap this review up right here. I just want to thank the people that work here because they were so friendly to give me the key to the GT2RS, which is just way too cool. And I'm also going to make a review about the GT3. So if you want to see that, I'll link it on the end of this video. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.